Guys, welcome to another video. So, as you finally know that we have the festival playlist going on and the winter season is already here. So, when I go to the winter season for the first time, it shows 25% complete. I think that's because we have done the Edinburgh Station Circuit and the CD7 already. So, yeah, we just need 25% and then we can unlock the number 88, RTR Mustang. To do that, first let's take a look at the Forzathon challenge. Did I do the Forzathon challenge last week? Yeah, I did. So for this one, this is called Long Standing Tradition. Own and drive the 2011 Ford Transit Supervan. Yeah, we can do that. Win 2 road races, easy. Earn 8 bin man skills. Okay, we can do that. We just have to go to the city to do that. And 10 trading paint. Yeah, it should not be that hard. So let's do the Forzathon challenge first. So to do that, so what I'll do is first I'll get, let me see what's the message, daily payouts. Okay, so let me go and change the car. So we need a Ford Transit Supervan. Yes, we already have that and it is already tuned to A-class, so we don't need to work on it anymore. So we are in the car and this is done. Now we have to go and win 2 road races, right? Why does it say not own? Ford Transit Sport Supervan, yeah. 2011. Super Sport Van, what is ours? I think, yeah, Super Sports Van. I think it might take a minute to get the achievement. We still haven't got it. I don't know why that is. Why does it say not owned? Own and drive the latest model. You know what? I think I'll start with the second one and let's see if it works. So win 2 road races, sprint races. Okay. So we go to road racing. We have to win the sprint ones. Yeah, we can do this one. I just wanted to trigger the notification first for the first Forzathon challenge, but yeah, that's not happening. I don't know the reason behind it, but that's not happening. You know what, let's go and do the race anyways. And we'll see how this car fares and let's just keep our fingers crossed that we'll get the Forzathon challenge. Because we have, I think there's a bug. If it's not working, I think there's a bug. So let's restart the race. Everyone has, no, not everyone has a port armor. So I think there's a Maloo pickup truck as well. This one, the green one, give chase. That's something else. I'm liking this van. I've seen some people on the internet tune it to F2 class, and they said that it's a very good handling car, even despite it being a van, but it's a super sport van. Okay, so we are on second place. We just need to overtake this guy and then we will be on first. We are drafting, but we are not able to overtake him. Yep, finally. Yep, so we are in the first place, and I just hope that after this race, it shows that we have done the first one, challenge one. Not really sure if that will work. I'll just check it. No, I cannot check it right now. But the race is almost done. 85%. Yep, that's done. We win this one. We did not get it. For every generation of the Transit, Ford builds a Supervan. Own and drive the latest model, the 2011 Ford Transit Supervan. That is what we have, right? That is what we have. It's the 2011 Ford Transit Super Sport Van, yeah. You know what, I think I'll just go to the auto show. And I'll just maybe buy a new one. Maybe that will trigger it. The game, it's not perfect. Sometimes it has a little bit of bugs and all, but overall it's a good game. So we'll go to the auto show, we all, and Ford Transit Supervan. 50,000, yeah. Let's just get one more of these. Just to make sure we trigger the challenge. I like the UPS one more. Okay, let's get the UPS one. I hope this triggers the challenge. So I think we just have to drive it a little bit. Expect delivery completed, finally. Just to make sure, like we don't make any mistakes, I think I'm going to upgrade this one only. And I'll upgrade it to A class. You know what, I'll upgrade it to S1 class, because yeah, why not? I already have one A class, right? Yeah, 875. How are people getting S2 class with this? Is there any S2 class? Nope. So it was only S1 class, which is the highest one for this one. A 1041 horsepower, and the weight goes down as well. Hmm. I like this, but I think it'll be a good idea if we tune it ourselves so that you guys can also see what customization options we have for this this car. So let's go and do that. First, let's see. Yeah, we have a lot of engine options. We have the 3.2 liter straight six. We have the 6.2 liter V8, 5.2 liter V8 DSC. Okay. How much horsepower does it have? 662. Yeah, that's a lot. You know what? I think I'm going to go with this one. 662. So as you can see, our target is to get 1000 horsepower out of this thing. After all these upgrades, I think we are close. Can we add a turbo? Yeah, we can. We can twin turbo it, and I think there should be a turbo one. Yep, this one. 1041 bhp. Cool. The drivetrain, make it all-wheel drive. Yeah, sure. Let's upgrade the brakes. The suspension, I think the race suspension is probably the best one for this one. Anti-roll buff, definitely we are going to need that. We don't need the roll cage because it's going to add a lot of weight. Weight reduction, yes. Let's put in a race clutch. The aero, yep. Oh yeah, it's the bumper. It's a bit hard to see from this angle. Yep, as you can see. I think the stock one looks better, but yeah, I think I'm going to go with the stock one. Looks much better, and there is not much difference. Yeah. I think I'll keep it the normal one. So all that is left with the tires and all. So tire compound. It is winter, so I think I'll go with the snow tires. Let's make them wide. Yep. We'll come back to alloys. Yep, let's do that. Let's make them stick it out as well. And the alloys. So we are at 857 right now, I think. Yep. So let's see what's the best. 858. Can we get 859? I think 858 is the highest one. I like these ones. Is that it? Drivetrain, yeah, that's all done. Yep, a S1 878. I'm just thinking, like, if we put a 6.2 liter V8, our weight goes down, but the power goes down a lot. But can we upgrade it? I'll just give it a shot. And just see how much horsepower we can get out of this thing if we use this engine. Yeah, all done. And we need to put a turbo, I think, again. Yeah, we can get 798 horsepower if we put a positive displacement supercharger, or we can put a twin turbo. I think if you go twin turbo, that keeps the weight down. So let's go twin turbo, and let's upgrade to turbo as well. 970 bhp, 970, and we are a fair bit lighter as well. Yep. Let me just make sure it's fully upgraded. Yep, all done. No. Okay, we have to add the race intercooler. 1016 horsepower. And yep. So we are set, and we are at 1016 horsepower, and we are a fair bit lighter as well. I think I'll buy and install these parts. Let's get some of these as well, because we are going to spending a little bit of time with the car, and things like these, they are always beneficial. Yep. Looks good to me. Let's also see the top speed of this thing. So go to tuning. 210 miles per hour, which is okay. Which is okay for an S1 class car. So I don't think I'm going to mess about with this one. Yeah, that's fine. Let's go for a quick test drive, and then let's resume the Forzacon challenge. It's really good, I think. It's quite fast. We need to make so to turn in, we need to brake a little bit early, because it's winter as well, and it's like the roads are completely snowed out. But you know what, let's just compare our tune first. Let's just use the wheel spin, and then we'll compare our tune to the top tune in the Creative Hub. So S1 class. So this guy, he's using a different engine, but he's a lot heavier, as you can see. And I think that power, like, we have the better power to weight ratio, I think. He has a little bit better launch, braking, acceleration and speed, and I think that is down to the tires. So he might be using the sports tires, that is why he's at S1875, but we are using the snow tires because we have made this car for winter. So let's go and do another. Let's go and do this one again. No, actually, let's go and do another one. Yep, we can do this one. Enter event solo. now we have two transit vans for some reason, even though the auto show wrote that it's owned by us. But yeah, at least we triggered the challenge. So guys, you can try doing it this way if the challenge does not trigger for you. You're doing so good in the corners, it's like, I think in these high speed corners, the car is really good. Yeah, even in the low speed corners as well, like if you follow the braking line and you brake at the correct time. Yeah. It's good. We got the checkpoint. Let's see how this car is at wall riding. Not bad. I think because it's a van, it's made for this sort of stuff. We are so much faster than the other people. Okay, so it does not like to change directions very fast, but that is to be expected because it is a van. And you guys have to like make sure that you have to consider the fact that it is winter and the roads are really slippery as well. So maybe that's part of the reason. But overall, this is a very good car. It's not tuned to the top of this one class because it cannot go that high. But even for like almost the mid of S1 class, this is quite good. Yep, it drifts as well. So this is done. So let's see if the Forzathon shows that we have done this. We need to keep checking. Yeah, so it says tap to progress 1 out of 2, that means we have done one of them. Yeah. For the next one, I think I will want to go to the city maybe. You can also do this one. We cannot do this because it's a circuit. Yeah, we can do this one. Let's go and do this one. So remember that we have to do the sprint races because it says so in the challenge. So if you do the road racing series but you do a circuit race, I don't think you're going to get the chapter progress. So make sure you do only the sprint races. Start the race. So many four transplants. It's too slippery, so you have to brake a little bit early. We are on first place and it's just 20%. Let's fall right this one. Okay, that was super fun. That was really fun. This car, I think it's really good for wall riding if you are the type sort of a person who likes to wall ride every corner. Yeah, go for it. During an online adventure, I think if you're a like if the track has like too many sharp corners and you are using the Ford Transit and you think like you might not be able to stop in time, so you can just wall ride. It's not recommended, but in this game it is sometimes the faster way to do things. So it might help you in the online adventure, and in the online adventure I've seen many people do it. So yeah, you can give it a shot with this car, because in some cars, like if you try to wall ride, like the side of the car is not that smooth, so like when you wall ride it, just like it goes really badly, like the car is going to get stuck somewhere and it's going to just bounce back. So that does not help, but if you do it with a car like this, which has a very like it's a very simple and like it's a very clean back side, like the side is like very plain and straight. So yeah, anyway, let's go to the Positon. Earn 8 binman skills. I think for the binman skills, yep, we have to. How many did we get? I think 3. Yep. No, we have to go inside and get. We only did 1. So maybe we should not have destroyed all those dustbins. We should have only destroyed just one of them. We got one more. Can we go back and do it again? No. There are no dustbins. But I think the best place to find the bins is the city. So we'll go to the city, and we're already in the city, but let's go to a different lane and see if we can find any dustbins going post. The city's maybe, yeah, the city is active. In the city you'll find a lot of these trash cans, but I think no, these are not flash cans. Oh, I think we missed a couple. I think there are a few on this side as well. Yeah. How many are done? I think we're done with 4, maybe. We're done with 5. Okay. We just need to do 3 more. We just need to do 3 more. So yep, there's a dustbin right there. So we got one more. I think I saw a dustbin over there. No, that's something else. So let's go to a different lane, because this lane was pretty good for us. But I think we need to move on and go to a different lane. So there's a dustbin. We missed that one. We got one. Trash talk completed, yep. 10 trading pain skills. So we can either do that in the city, or I think the best way to do it is on the highway. But let's try with the city first. Trading pain 1, yep. So this road, it always has traffic. We just have to like simply graze them. It's a lot harder to do than it seems like. Yep, I think that is good. But we did not get anything for that. We go back to that road again. Because that road is always full of traffic. What? No traffic at all? Yep, finally. I'm not getting anything. Trading pain finally. How many inputs done? 4. We're done with 4. We need 6. So yeah, this is also a great way to do it. If you are in this section of the city. We did 3, but I don't know, the game recognized. Yeah, the game did. Even though we are not getting, like, it's not showing that trading paint, it only showed once, but the game is recognizing. Let's just miss that. Let's try to get it from here. Yep, got it. Does that one count? Even if we crash? Yep, it does. It's almost done. We just need to do 2 more and we will be done with this follow on challenge. So let's go back to that road. Yep. Can we do it using the video? Got this. I think we only have to do 1 more. Trading pain, yep. Completed. The Forzathon challenge is completed. We get the 100 skill points. And I forgot to show you guys. In the Forzathon shop. Okay. That's a good Forzathon shop. So I don't really care about the auto union type D. But I do care about the 2019 Porsche 911 GT3 RS. I think I have the GT3 RS. I don't know which one I have. I'll just go to change car. See. Porsche. Yep. So we have the 911 GT3 RS, but we have the 2016 one. It's tuned to S2 class. And 8, 9.6, 8.4, 9.6. It's a pretty good car. The stats are really good. I'm not sure about the 911 GT3, like the 2019 one. But yeah, I think the newer cars in the game, they're really good. And if you go to the festival series, we have done 42%. Just from doing one Forzathon challenge, we came from 25% to 42%. So that's pretty cool. So I'll definitely go and do this one. It should not take long. I took long because I was customizing the car. But for you, you can just download my tune. I'll just upload the tune and you can just simply download the tune and do it. So I'll just save the setup. I'll just put best winter load. Okay. No, I cannot load mode. Best winter race, I'll just put. Okay, and then you guys can just go and simply find my team and download it. So it's made for all around, I would say. And yeah, it's a good all around car. The description, I will say, just it's for winter race. Let's put definitely. Yep. Share. So there you go, guys. I've shared the file, and yeah, we had to go and get the 911 GT3 RS so that we can compare. We have to go to Follow-Thon shop, right? Yep. I think we'll go from here. Yeah, Follow-Thon. It's a common car. How much is it for? I want to see that. It's 750, because 750 points is a lot, and I will want to save it if I can. So let's just go to the auto show and see if we can get it. Or maybe we can also check the. We can also go and check the auction house and see how much people are selling it for. And then we can decide for ourselves whether it's worth spending the points or the money. So 911 GT2 RS, GT3 RS. So many Porsche. I don't think I see 2019. This is the Carrera S, and for that you have to download. We'll go to the auction house. We'll go to Porsche. Porsche. Yep. So 911 GT3 RS 19. Yep. This is the car which we're looking for. No auctions to display. So even though that car, it might not be that special, but it is special to other people, and there is no auctions. And yep, I think I'm going to get it now because we have the Follow-Thon shop points, and it's been a long time since anything good came up. So yeah, I'll just try it for a second. Bear with me, guys. Porsche 911 GT3 RS. And so it's a little bit better than the other one. Yeah, it's a little bit better. I think it can make a great S2 class car once you have fully tuned it. Yeah, the handling is good. Let's see how it handles on the snow. It's a bit hard to control on snow, I think. I think I'm going to give it another chance, and I'm going to first customize it, because right now, it's, as you can see, it's rear wheel drive. So we will make it all wheel drive, and we'll see how it fares when we take it for S2 class race in the next video. And there will be winter, it will be still the winter season, so we are going to be putting on some snow tires as well, and we definitely need all wheel drive for the winter. Alright guys, that'll be it for this video. Let me know in the comments if you like the video, and you can feel free to download the tune which I've uploaded for the Ford Transit Super Sport van, and let me know how it works for you. So that'll be it for this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Cheers.